Hello again, folks. Welcome to another edition of Between the Banks. I'm Bob Gouge. It's 44 degrees, nice and cold, but the wind has laid, hardly any tide. And I'm going to show you where you can catch fish under those conditions this week on Between the Banks. Another Rock'em Sock'em edition of Between the Banks. Let's see what I got on. Probably a bull red or a big red. Take a break here. When we come back, it's on, folks, in Bayou Lafourche. Stay tuned. I'll give you all the details. Between the Banks is brought to you by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Louisiana.
This is our love, this is our life, this is our home, Louisiana. This is our day.
Take the short drive to Lafourche Parish, where both history and adventure await. Explore the historic Laurel Valley Plantation, the E.D. White Historic Site, and Bayou Lafourche Folklife and Heritage Museum. Discover the Acadian culture at the Wetlands Acadian Culture Center. Treat yourself to an exciting fishing trip or relax on a guided swamp tour. And sample true Cajun cuisine at one of the many unique restaurants. Call or log on to visitlafourche.com.
Folks, everybody gets Between the Banks. Here's how easy it is. Go to your address bar, type in betweenthebanks.com, search, and here you are. The latest videos, services, and products provided by Between the Banks. Check it out, betweenthebanks.com. Everybody gets Between the Banks. Think he's wrapped. All right, so what I've got here is I've got a line with heavy weight, quarter ounce. That's heavy for me. It's casted out into the middle of Bayou Lafourche. It's sitting in about 30, 40 feet of water. Okay, and that's the line that got hit. Now, if you look at the back of the boat, I've got another line. Check it out. It's in the gunwale of the hull right here. You can see, check out the reel. That line is a finger mullet line. And if you look at the top, you can see I got a free swimming finger mullet on a 30 pound test leader swimming in the back, working the other drop off. If you're gonna catch fish in Bayou Lafourche, you gotta know what the bottom looks like. And there's a big deep trench that goes down the middle. And that's deepest part of it, 40 feet right under the bridge. So, it comes from 40 up to 12, 10 foot ledge that creeps up towards the bank. This finger mullet is swimming in that shallow water. Without any weight on him, he can free swim. This line, bull reds, anything big that's in that big trench. And then sometimes I'll throw another line with a clip-on weight, maybe a 16th of an ounce, and throw it out into the middle and let it carry it to the ledge where that 12-foot, 10-foot ledge is. So the key is to spread your baits over all this structure. And there's plenty structure on the bottom here. If your weight's too heavy and you end up on the bottom, you're gonna get snagged. So if you're getting snagged, you know to loosen up the weight, lighten it up. Oh, got him fairly close to the boat. And then this is, let me give you the how. Since it's winter time, two rules. Fish deep and fish slow. That's why my rods are in the holder. There's no casting them out and holding them. Gotta put them in the holder because the fish are lethargic. That means they're not aggressive. So, I'm using light line because it's winter time. I don't want to come out here with my big rods. The line is too thick. It's not, they're not sensitive enough. So I'm going to use light line so my finger mullet and my live cockahoes, huge ones, are going to swim free. I got a lot of action. The fish are sitting there on that structure. And when that bait gets up on top of them, it's moving. Eventually, they're going to come hit it. So I'm rigged on my Team Daiwa gear. 12-pound test, 30-pound test shock leader. This is 12-pound ProSpec thin diameter line. On my reels, this is a Revo 3000H by Daiwa. It's coming up, but he ain't there yet. Now all my gear, everything, you can get over at Tides. And this is really fine equipment. Oh, coming towards the surface. Boy, it'd be nice if this was just a monster big trout, wouldn't it be? But I know it isn't. Nope, it's a bull red. Check them out. All right. Got him right in the roof of the mouth. I'm gonna get the net. See if I can get him in the net here. Come on over here, big boy. There he is. Big old bull red. Swimming in the middle of Bayou Lafourche. Don't forget, all this tackle, rod and reel combo, you can go over to Tides, they got their big sale still going on. $150 with the line. So on the Boga grip, this fish is 20 pounds. 20 pound bull red. All right, we're gonna unhook him, release him. Stay tuned. Believe it or not, there's some really big specks here too. Maybe we'll get into them. Stick with us. That water's colder this time of year, so you don't have to really revive them a whole lot. They'll get going. It's a long fight of catching them with a white line, light line. You gotta make sure they release good because it really wears them out. All right, I'm gonna get rebaited up, but first I'm gonna show you my bait. Stay tuned. All right, now, during the winter time, one of the benefits staying at Boudreaux's Waterfront Motel is if you have a cast net, you can cast net the canal where the boats are. Now, you don't want to do it when there's boats all over the place. You want to do it when the canal is quiet. Throw cast net and you're going to catch finger mullet. So I get my minnows, of course, from T. Rand over at Blessed Trinity. And you can see how big they are. I mean, look at the size of these cockahoes. Check that out. That's a cockahoe. You know, that's a really big cockahoe. T. Rand uses big mesh in his minnow traps. So the small ones come in and go out. When he lifts his traps, they're all big. So that's why T-Rain gets big minnows when there are big minnows available. But when I'm fishing specks, I gotta show you my favorite speckled trout bait. Finger mullet. Look at that. That's a baby mullet, finger mullet, and I catch them in my cast net. Yesterday, when we were getting ready to go fishing, we threw the cast net and caught about 20 of them. And I rig them right through the lips. See how I've got that hook running through the lips right there, coming out right before the skull on the bait. Really an excellent bait to fish with. So during the winter time, you throw your cast net and catch big bait, big finger mullets. There are times where I won't even use cock hose. I'll just get 25 or 30 finger mullet and come out here and really hammer some nice fish. Bull reds, bull drum, and some big specks. Great place for the winter time. Fish deep, fish slow, rig like this, and you're gonna catch some big fish. Let's see what happens next. Another one. Ugh. Broke me off or bent the hook or something. So that's one of the things you're faced with when you're fishing in all the trash. You're gonna snag and you're gonna break off. So what I do is I make leaders ahead of time. This is just pipe insulation. And what I'll do is I'll make up leaders, just stick them on here, unwrap them, and I don't have to make a brand new leader. I can just tie it directly to the line. Let me give you a close look. Now my free, again, winter time, I always use clip-on weights. This is a one-aught kale hook. I'm fishing light. Even though there's bull reds, I'm catching them on a one-aught kale hook, 30-pound test leader material, low vis, with a black crane swivel. Let me show you that swivel. That's a number 10. Okay, and I'm using that because I want to keep the twist out of the line. And that's what I'm tying directly onto the line. Then I'm coming with a split shot. And I'm putting this split shot right below that leader, on the leader, but below that swivel. And the split shot size is from 1/16, 1/32nd, up to 1/8. And then 1/4 I'm using through barrel weight. So the weight is dictated by how much current it's taking to get the bait right above all the structure. So if I don't want to get snagged, now that I had a 1/8 ounce on, I'm gonna go to a 1/16 because it got snagged. And the tide is slack, remember, slack tide. So now it's turned and it's coming in with a southwest wind blowing. So I'm gonna lighten up because our lines are getting snagged. So there's another tip. Again, all the swivels, hooks, all that stuff, you can get it tied and ask them for the between the banks combo. It's top of the line gear. The whole combo, 150 with the line and everything, and you're using really good equipment here. Team Iowa Rod, 7-foot medium action on that Revos or the Gallus reel. You're gonna love it. All right, so I'm getting back out there. Stay tuned. You know, folks, we always tell you just how it happens and what's going on. This morning, I just had to come fishing. Even though it's 44 degrees and it's cold and high pressure is on us, it's a brutal day, but when you love to fish, sometimes you're gonna go on those brutal days. Now tomorrow is our prime day for fishing. We're gonna have moving water, it's warming up, it's supposed to be on. But we had to come fishing today. And all we caught so far was those two bull reds. One we caught, the other one broke us off. And that's it. I'm at Redfish Point 2. There's fish all over the place on sonar. Really marking big time fish. Look at the spot where my cork is. You can see the slick. Look at that big shiny slick coming through here. Right through the trench at Redfish Point number 2. Passing right through the trench. So fish are on sonar, but these days when you fish, when the high pressure's coming to you and it's going up or it steadies, those are the brutal days. And everybody has them. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna pitch it to the marina minute. You know, Boudreaux's, tie your boat to your bed. Griffin's right across from Boudreaux's, fuel both sides, dock and road. Great food, great grill. Then renovations, all the shows that are coming up, the Homer show, the New Orleans show, and the Sportsman show. They'll be in all three of them. Let's go check out the Marina Minute. And when I come back, as a special treat, since the fish aren't whacking us here, I'm going to show you. I've had a lot of email from people that say we still don't know how to get to the South Texco field, which is one of my favorite places to fish and where I should have gone today. But I figured y'all be tired of seeing us catch fish there. So let's go to Marina Minute. We'll follow it with the map. Stay tuned. And don't worry, if a fish bites, we'll let you know.
Boudreaux's Waterfront Motel. Dock your boat at the end of the pier right under your room.
Set up your grill. Got your own fish cleaning station. Your own ramp.
And for big groups, enjoy the sunset at the Boudreaux House.
Boudreaux's
in Leeville.
Griffin's Marina and Ice has bag, block, and blown ice for whatever size boat. Both dockside and roadside ethanol-free fuel, convenience store, breakfast, crispy chicken, all conveniently located in downtown Leeville.
Renovations is your complete marine center. Minn Kota, Motor Guide, Power Pole, Sales and Service, Trailer Parts, Bilge Pumps, their friendly, helpful staff will keep you on the water. Hardware, marine, and home decor are at Renovations.
All right, folks, here's the map feature. Notice the back end of the boat's in 3.6 feet of water. We started at 49 degrees this morning on the surface water temp, but it's warming up, so we're 55.2 now. And then I've got maybe 1/10 of a knot current speed. Look at all the fish, mid-range and throughout the thermocline. All of them 1.5 feet down on this little ledge. And then I got a full chart on the other when we go right over the trench. All right, so let's go pages. Let's go map, enter. Okay, so here's the map feature, and I've kind of situated my chart, my Lowrance, this way so you can see exactly how to come in. So we came out of Boudreaux's Canal, came into the West Canal, and came to Bayou Lafourche. Then I stopped at 03, right there, just when you fall into Bayou Lafourche on that east bank, that's where we anchored this morning and hit those bull reds. Now, came down to Redfish Point number 1, okay? Here's where all the jackups are. Right when you pass that last jackup, you're coming into the South Texaco field. Number 12 is Redfish Point 1. That's the intersection of Bayou Lafourche and the entrance to the South Texaco field. You're going to follow the canal in and follow it around until you come to this island. Little bitty island. If you look really good, you can see it. In fact, let me zoom in. Might take a little while to do it, but it'll be worth it. See, you can see Redfish Point 2, number 13, where the boat's at. This is this little island. Now, to get to into Dease Canal, where we do a lot of shows, you're simply going to come around Redfish Point 2. You're going to hug this bank, not this side, mudflat, this bank. You're going to come in, and then you're going to come to what I call the Cribbin Canal. That's the next canal on your left. Then there's a cribbin right here. I'm passing on the left side of that cribbin. It's shallow, but no problem getting in. And then you fall into Dease Canal, Dease Pond. That's 006, where I always fish when I'm at Dease Canal. All right, so folks, here I've zoomed in as close as I can go. 100-yard scale here. So this is Redfish Point 1, Bayou Lafourche, and the entrance. You're going to come in, you're going to pass the old canals, come around the curve, and there's Redfish Point 2, number 13. Now you can see the island that I'm passing by, and then you can also see where I come into Dease Canal. This is where the cribbin is. I'm passing just on that left side of the cribbin. So that gives you a real tight shot on how to get into the South Texaco field. With the islands and everything else, there's Bayou Lafourche, the end of the jackups, you're turning in. Okay, so there gives you a whole bunch of all the people that have been saying, show us how you go into Dease Canal and the South Texaco field. All of this is oysters. I mean, this is just a great place to fish during the winter time. Great place. And it's right off of Bayou Lafourche. So, Redfish Point 2, where I'm at, coordinates north 2914306, west 9012906. Redfish Point number 2, number 13 on our chart. I'm not going to save it because I've already got it. So, number 13, there's the map feature. All right, check it out. Home of Boat Show February 19th through February 21st at the Houma Municipal Auditorium. Also, February 21st, benefit for Lindell Toops at the Gaines Community Center. Lindell is a past councilman for Lafourche Parish for many years. He's ill, and we're trying to raise some money to help him with all the expenses of that he's going through. So that's Sunday, 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. at the Gaines Community Center. Now also, the New Orleans Boat Show, that's going to be March 4th through the 6th, Friday, March 4th through Sunday, March 6th, New Orleans Boat Show. Then the Sportsman Show this year, March 17th through March 20th. At all of those shows, Renovations is going to be there. I'll be there. The gang will be there. Make sure you come by and see me. I'll have some neat giveaways and stuff, and I'll be doing little seminars at the booths and stuff. So definitely check it out. Houma Boat Show, New Orleans Boat Show, and the Sportsman Show. Renovations is going to be at all three, and don't forget the benefit for Lindell Toots. Sunday, February 21st from 11 to 5 p.m. Gaines Community Center. All right, let's see what's coming up next. Well, folks, there you have it. Another edition of Between the Banks. Definitely not a rock'em sock'em edition. Fishing a tough day. We should have stayed, left the boat on the trailer, piddled around, but you know how it is. I just love to fish. Now tomorrow, we've got a great day forecasted. Another front coming, but later on, we've got southeast winds, barometric pressure is going to be falling, moving water. We ought to do a lot better. And it's a shame y'all have to go. But next week, tune in and see just what happened when the weather got right. Hopefully it's going to be a tale of two fishing days. So, we'll see you next week with another edition of Between the Banks. In the meantime, good luck, folks.